This is a USB 3.0 CVBS capture card. What is bulk mode? If your video capture card complies with bulk, at the same point in time, you can insert multiple video capture cards. Take this as an example. I inserted the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 at the same time. The CVBS capture card is on this computer. This is the USB hub. Then I can turn on the computer's OBS. Screenshots of these 5 video capture cards. At the same time, it will be displayed on the computer. Look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 video source. From this CVBS video capture card. I'll break this, you see. Look. Take it back. The source of the video is from this CVBS splitter. This is a USB 3.0 Fathom 100 capture card. It is USB bulk mode.
This is new USB 3.0 Fathom 100 CVBS capture card. It is USB 3 mode. Of course, it also have a 3D converter and a 3D interface. In this video clip, I will test this CVBS capture card performance. New USB 3.0 Fathom 100 CVBS capture card. I will test the video frame rate and the video format and the video quality. The video quality includes the 3D converter and the 3D interface. I will compare with the China Chip capture card EasyCap for the compare demo. Connect to the PC and the CVBS source. I turn on the app ANCAP, this one. I check the video frame rate. This is YUV and the motion JPEG. YUV is up to the 60 FPS. The resolution is 720 by 418. And this one, okay? And the motion JPEG up to the 60 FPS. The resolution is the same as the YUV. Okay, I use the YUV. And I also play a video. Okay, we will compare with the China Chip capture card. If no 3D converter, what will happen? I turn on the ANCAP again and get the China Chip capture card. This one. You can see the compare. The China Chip capture card will have a more lag, and our capture card do not have a more lag. More lag. This is more lag. Okay, I will test another. This is test the 3D interface. You can see the China Chip capture card, it have a jacky. What I demo before is NTSC version. NTSC version resolution is up to the 720 by 418. Now I will use the PAR version. PAR version is up to the 720 by 576. Just the resolution difference. The function are the same. Turn on the APP ANCAP. This one. USB 3 video. And you can see its video performance. Okay, YUV up to the this one, 720 by 576. And the frame rate is 16 YUV. And the motion JPEG is up to the this one. And the frame rate is also 16. We also can test the 3D converter about this PAR version capture card. Okay, I changed the video source of this multimedia box. The video resolution is still PAR version. And the video source is still PAR. See, PAR version. And then I tested the 3D converter. You see, it do not have a more lag. Okay. And also test the interface. You see, it's jacky. The jacket is very small. The second, I will test the video latency for the new Fibon 100 Cbps CB capture card. I will use the TV monitor compared with the notebook. The capture card will connect to this notebook, so we can compare the number difference. But there are many details to be considered. The TV monitor have the video latency, so we need added the TV monitor video latency with the difference. And the second, the video source is from the PC watch. It is HDMI output. I need to connect a HDMI splitter. One connect to the TV monitor. The second HDMI output, I will connect to the HDMI to CBPS adapter. The HDMI to CBPS adapter also have the video latency. I do not know what it is. Maybe 30ms, maybe 20ms. So when you use the HDMI to CBPS connect to this adapter, the video latency will be higher. It is very hard to calculate the real video latency, but we can know the video latency is a range. The TV monitor video latency is about 30ms. The capture card connect to the PC, and we can calculate the video latency between the PC and the TV monitor is about 100ms. But the 100ms is including this adapter. This adapter is HDMI to CBPS adapter. So how do we calculate the finally video latency of this new capture card? I think the video latency of this capture card is do not higher than 100ms plus 30ms. The highest video latency is about 130ms. Finally, I will do the combat blow test. I will test the new USB 3 Fibon 100 Cbps capture card working on the Mac and work on the Raspberry Pi and the Android 4. Finally, I will test the capture card working on iPhone. If you connect my company product, USB webcam docking station, or USB webcam to Lightning adapter. First, test the capture card work on the Mac. Second, test the capture card work on the Raspberry Pi. The third, test the capture card work on Android phone. The fourth, test the capture card work on iPhone.